No break, no jam, no sense. Joro, jara, joro, joro, joro.
My name is Aniku Lagbo. I have death in my power. They can't kill me.
Turn up! Felati, Banawa. I want to light up the shawarma.
Hey guys, hello, welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's your girl, Jola Billions. And today, listen, I don't have time for intro. Today, we are going to Kalakuta Museum. We're going to Fela's house. Did you hear me? We are going to Fela's house. We're going to visit the mentor to most Nigerian artists, the mentor to some of your boyfriends. Okay, I'm just kidding. But that man is a legend. The house is quite large, so I'm going to try to show you guys everything or almost everything, because at the end of the day I'm going to have to edit the video and then I don't want it to be too long so as not to bore you guys. But I'll be showing you guys the most important aspects of Fela's house, and you can also pay a visit so you can see the house yourself. Okay, all right guys, please do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, and I'm so happy we finally made it to 1k subscribers. This is like motivation for me to keep doing what I'm doing. I believe you guys see something in me, which is why you're subscribing. All right guys, so come with me, we're going to the museum.
1998 to 1997.
This is the grey we are.
As when I was editing this video, I realized my face didn't show much. So there is a tour guide that takes you through the building, explain the picture and every other thing in the house to you. So you guys should enjoy the tour guide explaining things to me and some other people that were there in this video. All right, bye guys.
It's now a museum now. They call it a museum. So here's the last one with him. This was 1958. So this was when he was leaving for Trinity College. To study music. Those 27 women, they were all his dancers.
Yeah.
And backup singers as well. Mm-hmm. So his first house that got this woman, they all
stood by him.
Yeah, they were all inside. Yeah. They were all brutalized by his soldiers. Yeah. All of them, they were paraded naked on the street by soldiers. So it was a year after he was having remembrance of the house.
Yeah.
So the man now said that all these women,
they stood by him when they broke down the part time.
So you know Yemikuti, I'm sure. So we know his first son, Femi, at the shrine. So that was the second daughter. So this one died after her father, same year. So this one was his mistress.
Yeah.
Side chick.
Yeah.
So she gave birth to Shalua Kuti. 27 women. You only had 2 children for him. I'm not sure you're aware. I only 2 children came
out of all
out of that 27.
Yeah. This is Mume.
Okay.
And that's your mother.
Oh. Okay.
And that's Deka. This is Deka. It's actually a record label. But they used to call them musical company. Okay. So it's an American musical company.
That's Decca.
So they came into Nigeria and had an agreement with all these big artists in Nigeria. And Decca messed up with everybody, including Fela. But this Fela is part of the story. Decca was headed by a white man, not until Obasanjo came into power. So when Obasanjo came into power in the United States, he nationalized Decca and removed the white guy and put Abiola. I'm sure we know Ikeja. So when Mto became the chairman of Decca, Fela began having issues with Decca. And it got to a point they had to push their contract with him. So after the contract was pushed, Fela walked up to Decca's office and told them that you guys were owing me, let me say, like royalties, and they need to pay him off. And Decca refused to pay it. So Fela left the office, went back to his house. He packed everybody in that house to Decca's office. And when they go there, they beat all the Decca staff. He chased them out of the office and took over the office for like 79 days. Here is Fela in 1978. He had a political party. Fela ran for presidency.
The name of this party is More Movement of the People. So the only way the Nigerian government to stop him was to kick out the party. If not, Fela would win the election. Fela, he was living in a courtroom and people came out to support him.
Yeah.
Just to show their love to him.
Yeah.
So these are some of those women that
he got married to.
Sandra Isabel of Isabel. So she's an African American. Mm-hmm. She was a member of the Black Panther. Mm-hmm. So Fela was invited to Black Panther convocation in 1969. There are 2 parts more used to be.
Interesting.
So and then after they brought Fela to the Black Panther movement in 1969, so this woman met Fela during the movement and then she asked Fela a lot of questions about Africa. Fela, this is where you're coming from. And she was, Fela didn't even know, she could listen to their autobiography.
Yeah.
And also Marcus Garvey, the likes of it. And she also gave Fela a lot of books to read.
Yeah.
And now Africans were being enslaved during the so-called anti-slavery trade in Africa.
Yeah.
So to even help Fela to open his mind,
it was
Sandra. So she gave him weed to smoke.
Interesting.
Yeah. That's the first time I've been to smoke weed. That has been all this after this natural thing. She radicalized. This is Sandra. Actually, Sandra came to Nigeria.
Yeah.
Yes. Like to live with Fela. She wasn't aware that Fela already had
so many
wives in the house. So those ones were frustrating her life.
Yeah.
This woman went back to America. But she's still alive.
She's still alive. You know when they did the Fela on Broadway, the one that Jada Pinkett produced.
Yeah.
She was even in the behind the scenes for how they.
Not even behind the scenes. She was on this set, on this station where they did for
Fela. Yes. I know the one. Finding Fela. Yes, they were on that one. Yeah.
She saw the traditional marriage for just 27 women. I did advance.
What?
It's a movie. It's just one movie. It is called The Black President. Nobody saw this movie.
Yeah.
Nobody.
Yeah.
You can't find it anywhere.
Yeah.
Saw it. The movie was totally destroyed in the first house.
But you said the three shots actually. How did they get this one?
Actually, I think the soundtrack of the movie. that's very interesting.
Yeah.
The soundtrack of the movie, everything was coming fine. So about 70% of the video footage was not in the fire. So the family only had 30% of the video footage. So that's where they got all this from. Even though they are playing the movie for you to watch, you don't understand anything about the movie.
They made a lot for you, so that's why I can
make it.
Okay.
This woman was one of the 27 wives. She was the best dancer of Fela. And Fela decided to make a song for her titled Lady. Wow. She will say, yeah. She will say.
They were made in Nigeria.
Not only in this house.
In this house.
And this one there, they are manifestos for his political party. The party he had in 1978 when he ran for presidency. So these are the manifestos. Then Malta, the reason is in pound. And that's his younger brother, Dr. Tobacco. So this is Fera with his first wife. His wedding reception. It was after his graduation I got married and his wife. She's late now. She stayed with him till he died. This is Fera, his younger brother. His older brother's wife. That's Fela, he was talking his way against his law.
This is Fela's quote that says, a man who's been slave forever.
we will never play the truth as one of the four parties.
They're for sale.
Yeah, they are matching values.
How much do this cost?
7,500, right?
7,500.
That's what you... This house in Ghana, it's a Fela's house. Like, the house actually stayed to the knife. And it officially named this house Kalakuta Republic.
What does Kalakuta even mean?
It's a name he got from his cell in a prison.
Oh.
He was locked in a prison in 1972, a prison called Alagun. So in that Alagun prison, there was a cell called Kalakuta cell. Now the cell was named maybe the former inmate who were inside. So it was when he came out of the Kalakuta cell, he decided to call the house Kalakuta Republic. Kalakuta actually came from this place in India. It's called Kalakuta. This house is installed Kalakuta on the last one. The first Kalakuta got destroyed in 1977, where his mom was killed.
So they now reduced this place?
No.
Second, Kalakuta. So let me just give you, in that house in 1984, it was being charged for money smuggling by Buhari government. So Buhari government locked him up for like 5 years. But it came out a year after. It was released by the Ramadan government. So that was when it came here. And the stage book.
Mm-hmm.
It was sponsored by Michelle Obama.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. You appreciate the visitation.